Hey, space friends, this week I am geeking out about tiny black holes, the tiniest of black holes. I really wanted to know about tiny black holes because, well, we often hear about all these supermassive black holes in our galaxy and in other galaxies, and supermassive black holes are awesome. They are known for gobbling up tons of stuff around them and then brightly vomiting it back out into the universe in the form of mixed up stuff. I actually did a video about black holes a while back talking about how they often get a bad rap as being these destructive forces of nature when, in fact, they are also creators of nature. They spit out and vomit out all this stuff that might be a really integral part of forming galaxies and planets and stars. So black holes do a lot of different interesting things in nature, and they are endlessly fascinating to study because there's just still so much unknown about them. But I wanted to know about the tiniest of black holes. Well, there's just one supermassive black hole at the center of our galaxy, and we often only see one supermassive black hole at the center of other galaxies. There are many tinier black holes all around us. These tiny black holes are known as stellar mass black holes because they are only a few times more massive than our sun, but there's many of them. In our Milky Way galaxy alone, there's thought to be many, many millions of tiny black holes all around us. Tiny black holes are hard to find because as supermassive black holes gobble up a bunch of stuff and vomit it out into the universe brightly and we can see their vomit, tiny black holes, it turns out, don't really vomit out all that much stuff. They don't gobble up a whole ton of stuff, and so they don't vomit out a bunch of stuff that we can see. So tiny black holes are even more invisible to us in terms of discovering them. So how astronomers and people are actually discovering tiny black holes is instead of looking for their vomit, they look for stars that are wobbling. These wobbly, orbiting stars might actually show that they're orbiting a hidden thing, and that hidden thing might be a black hole. So they look for stars that are wobbling around or orbiting things, but they can't see what they're orbiting. And if they can't see what they're orbiting, there's a good chance they may have found a tiny black hole. Until recently, the tiniest black holes that had been discovered were somewhere between 5 to 15 times the mass of our own sun, so 5 to 15 solar masses. In 2008, people got really excited because they think they discovered a black hole with 3.8 times the mass of our sun, but it got further reassessed and was established to more likely be somewhere between 5 to 10 times the mass of our sun. Theoretically speaking, the minimum mass for a black hole should be somewhere around 3 times the mass of our sun. So people wanted to keep looking to see if they could find even tinier black holes in nature. What's really exciting is that just in 2019, people think they discovered a black hole that is just 3.3 times the mass of our sun. This is really exciting. It's a tiny black hole located at the outer edges of our Milky Way galaxy, around 10,000 light years away from us, and is estimated to be around only 12 miles across. Just thinking about a tiny black hole sitting at the edge of our own galaxy that's no larger than many cities are is just kind of delightful to think about. The researchers who discovered this tiny black hole say that it's possible that this little invisible area that they discovered might instead be two neutron stars orbiting each other, but that's highly unlikely. So they think that they're pretty certain that they did actually find a black hole that is 3.3 times the mass of our sun, and thus the tiniest black hole that has been discovered in nature to date. Why it's so important to discover and find all these tiny black holes in nature is not only because they are adorable, but because they are really scientifically interesting. Neutron stars, which are the next densest object in nature next to black holes, are thought to maybe only be up to around 2.1 times the mass of our sun. So there's this interesting threshold between what turns into a neutron star and what turns into a black hole. The larger the dying star when it goes into supernova and then collapses, the more likely it goes towards a black hole. Smaller ones go towards neutron stars. But finding that threshold between what turns into a neutron star and what turns into a black hole is really fascinating. And the way to study it is to find those limits of the highest density neutron stars and the lowest density black holes. Hypothetically speaking, there might be even tinier black holes that have existed in our universe or may still be found to exist in our universe, but there's been no evidence for them yet. For example, primordial black holes are tiny black holes that are thought to maybe have existed in the early universe. But because they were so tiny and so long ago, They most likely have all evaporated by now, making it really difficult for us to find evidence of their existence. Some people theorize that the creation of microscopic quantum black holes is possible at the Large Hadron Collider Particle Accelerator. The idea behind this is that if gravity is stronger than we think it is, then maybe the Large Hadron Collider could create quantum microscopic black holes in proton collisions. But so far, even though people have been looking, they have not discovered any microscopic black holes being created. And thus that supports the idea that we currently have, which is gravity being a rather weak thing in our universe. The current science experiment that I'm personally really excited about when it comes to black holes is the DUNE experiment, the Deep Underground Neutrino Experiment Lab that's at the site of the Sanford Lab, which is the abandoned gold mine that I was able to explore a while back. It's an incredibly cool experiment that's currently being built out. But what they are doing that's so exciting to me is that they are trying to observe the birth of a black hole in real time by observing neutrinos. When a supernova happens and then begins to collapse down into a black hole, the idea is that a bunch of neutrinos would get shot out from that explosion and then quickly dissipate because they would all get subsumed by the black hole. So the exciting thing about the DUNE experiment and getting to actually study neutrinos is that they might actually be able to witness a black hole forming in real time, which is just really cool to think about. Okay, that's it for me. Check out the YouTube description below because there's always two important things I put in every YouTube description. First is a shout out to all the really awesome patrons for helping create videos like this one. Second is that I always put links that are relevant to each episode in the YouTube description if you want to read up more about the topics that I'm talking about. If you are interested in helping me create videos like this one, thank you so much. Head on over to my Patreon campaign and I really appreciate it. You can get cool stuff and geek out with me there week to week. Otherwise, I'll see you all next week and remember to always be exploring.